这样的佛教的空性呢，我们可以从性方面讲，因为过去的性观察的时候它已经灭完了，就刚刚一刹那之前的性已经灭完了，就根本得不到，它灭完了的东西不可能得到。
So for your question, we can do an observation of our mind. So for our mind, the mind of the past, it's already ceased, and we cannot have it anymore. We cannot attain it, gain it anymore.
未来的性和事物呢，得不到，因为它还没有产生。
And for the mind of future or anything in the future, we cannot have it because it has not yet arisen.
我们现在的性或者事物的话，也可以这样去观察。
And we can also observe things at present.
比如说，我们说现在的手表，在现象上是它是存在的，我的手也可以接触。
So we can see, for example, this watch, I can touch it at this moment.
但这是一个非常严重的错觉。
But this is just a big illusion.
真正用智慧来观察的是和现在的这个手表的本体是得不到。
But if we observe it, we will find that the nature of this watch cannot be found.
为什么得不到呢？因为事件当中的现在得不到。
Why we cannot find it? Because the present time cannot be found.
如果事件当中的现在得不到的话，依靠现在事件的手表也得不到。
If we cannot find the present time, and then the thing that is relied on the present time cannot be found.
为什么现在的事件得不到？因为所谓的现在是非常的细微，最细微的东西呢，我们观察的时候也没有。
Why we see that we cannot find the present time? That is because the present time is very subtle, and this subtle fragment of time can also be found.It does not have intrinsic existence. It's also emptiness.
因为你这个事件要么是过去，要么是未来，最后寻找现在的时候非常非常细微，最后细微的也得不到的话，那依靠它的这种事物得不到。
Because time can be either past or future, and if you look at right now at this subtle, this very very short time, is also emptiness, and that's why we see we cannot find the present time.
因此我们佛教讲一切事物的真正的它的本体是空的。
That's why we see the nature of all phenomena is empty.
最后我们在观察的时候，所谓的这个空呢，也是只是一个概念而已，也不存在。
And finally, the emptiness that we are talking about is also just an idea, a concept. It cannot be found either.
因此万法的实相不是有，不是无。不是于我而则，不是非于我而则以外的原理，四遍罢系。
So the ultimate reality of all phenomena is from the four extremes: existence, non-existence, both nor either.
这个空性的道理，如果你特别想了解的话呢，有《中观根本会论》和《中观庄严论》当中有细致的分析。
And if you do have the interest to understand emptiness, I recommend two books to you. One is the Fundamental Wisdom of the Middle Way, and the other one is Elements of the Middle Way.
如果我们很认真地去学习的时候呢，真的会明白，就是我们现在认为的万事万物的存在呢，这是一个假象而已。
And if you can take this seriously, to study it seriously, you will finally find that all phenomena that we can perceive right now are actually empty.
因为我们的逻辑上退的时候呢，就根本退不过去，最后真的是不存在。就像我刚才从时间上退的一样，还有无知有无知的，有六种微尘的一种围绕的方式来，就是进行观察。
This is because you will go through logical reasoning and you will find that everything is empty. And besides the analysis with time, we can also analyze things in space, in terms of space, with the six particles.
因此我们佛经里面讲，眼睛所看到的不一定存在，耳朵所听到的也不一定存在，所有的六根所得到的也不一定存在。
So in Buddhist scriptures, we see that what we can see through our eyes are not necessarily exist. And what we can hear by our ears are not necessarily exist. And anything that we can perceive through the sense faculty of us, anything that we can perceive through them are not necessarily exist.
感恩堪布为我们带来这么精彩的演说，让我们又增进了对无常的理解。接下来我们也精心准备了一些问题来请教堪布，这些问题都是我们从线上线下的观众分享收集得来的。首先第一个问题想请教您，很多在座的同学们对毕业以后从事什么样的工作感到迷茫，请问您在求学时有这种困惑吗？您当年是如何抉择职业选择成为一名堪布的呢？
Today many students worry about which career to take after graduationDo you have similar concerns when you were a student? How did you make the choice of being a Kanpo?
Kanpo
also can be understood as a teacher.
我当时放弃老师的工作，最后自然而然得到老师的工作。
Because I give up my job as a teacher, that's why I become a teacher.
因为我没有出家之前，我们是学师范学校，后来就会当老师，本来是这样的一个职位。
So before I was ordained, I was in a teacher's school or a normal school, we say that. And when I was studying in that school, I was supposed to be a teacher.
所以我当时放弃了当老师的这样的这个职业，但也没有想到最后自己都不知不觉都变成一个老师了。
So at that time, I give up my profession as a teacher, a worldly, mundane teacher, and then I became a teacher in Buddhism.
所以后来不知不觉换上了一个红色的衣服，把头发剃掉，然后又变成一个老师。我教书已经30多年了。
So just without my notice that I changed my clothes to this red robe and shaved my head and became a teacher in Buddhism, and I have already taught for over 30 years.
不过当时那个年代找工作没有竞争性，没有那么强。
And but in those years,there are not much competition for finding a job.
所以我找的工作就这样来的，我自己也不知道。
So this is story of how I found this job. I don't know more.
看看年轻的很多朋友寻找自己的人生的时候，也依靠一种自己的智慧的限制。
And I think for young people, when you have to find your ideal job, you need to use your wisdom to observe, to examine.
好的，谢谢您，谢谢。那么有第二个问题，就是现在很多的年轻人呢，感到非常的焦虑，甚至受到了抑郁症的困扰，在非常多的学校，自杀率呈现不同程度的增长。在您看来，各种精神疾病的根源在哪里？我们应该如何运用佛法的智慧，让内心回归平静呢？
Anxiety and depression are on the rise amongst today's youth. Suicide rates at schools around the country, including Colombia, have increased. With your teachings, how do you believe we can combat these serious issues?
其实心灵的这种疾病，当前来讲非常严重。
In fact, I think mental disease is very serious in this time.
在我们藏地所谓的抑郁症呢，到现在为止很多人都不知道。
And in Tibet, not a people even do not know there is a disease called depression.
在我所在的佛学院呢，人多的时候也有过几万人。
And in the monastery that I reside, in the different times, the biggest population is several dozens of thousand people.
我在那里待了32年。
I have been there for 32 years.
但到 目前为止我没有听过任何的因为心理问题而自杀的。
So far, I have not heard anyone committed suicide because of some mental disease.
所以我也特别想很多年轻人，包括我们刚才所讲到的心灵的一些知识，当前非常重要。
So I think it's very important for young people to understand more of the mental or spiritual approaches for their mind.
因为我们的人生不仅仅是依靠一种物质来满足，一定需要用一种精神的内在的一种修养。
Because our life cannot be satisfied with just the material things. We have to do some spiritual inner pursuit.
其实这样的内在的修养呢，在佛教当中，或者其他的宗教，或者其他的传统文化当中，应该是有很多很多的。
And when we want to cultivate spiritually or internally, there are a lot of things, a lot of approaches that we can use, not just within Buddhism.
我也建议很多人在生活当中，在学习当中，经常要学会放松的信仰，放下来，就放松的信仰，安住下来。
And I also want to suggest that people learn how to relax, how to let go a lot of attachments.
不能绷得太紧。
Don't have a lot of stress all the time.
追求的目标也不能太高。
And don't put a very high expectation for yourself.
因为我们追求的目标太高，压力非常大的，最后呢，自己的心里也会很容易出现各种问题。
If your goal is too hard to reach, then you will be stressful all the time, and finally you may have some problems in your mind.
我们需要努力的坚强的做事情，但是呢，也应该很放松的、很自然的。
So we should do things with a strong mind and do things actively. However, at the same time, we should control our mood, control our emotion, just to keep a peaceful mind.
其实有经常用这种方法来观察自己的心的话，也许你的工作的效率更高。
If you can examine.Or watch on your own mind. In this way, I think you will be more productive in your work, in your job.
因为我们生活当中心很重要的。
Because mind is very essential, very important in our life.
佛教的发句经知道吗？
发句经是
南传佛教的发句经里面有一句话叫做。心是最快的，心是最重要的，它一切的造作者。
And in Theravada Buddhism, there is a sutra called Dhammapada, and it says that our mind is the swiftest thing, the fastest thing.
经常观察自己的心，最后应该不管怎么样，我觉得很开心。
I think if we can always observe, examine our mind, we will be happy all the time.
谢谢大师的讲解。好的，那我们进入到第三个问题。很多人在问生命的意义是什么，如何才能过上有意义的人生？想请问您给自己的答案是什么呢？可以跟我们大家分享一下吗？
Many people are wondering, what is the meaning of life? How can one lead a meaningful life?What's your perspective on this question?
生命的意义，每个人的定位都不同。有些人有钱就是生命的意义，有些人长得好看就是生命的意义，有些人非常健康，这就是生命的意义。有些人跑步跑得快，这也是生命的意义。好多运动员，他们的生命的意义。好多明星他们的生命的意义，有些农民和有些工人他们的生命的意义，包括一些学者他们的生命的意义都不同的。但我自己认为呢，所有的生命的意义当中，帮助别人，因为我们需要别人 需要帮助的这些人，我们有一个利他的心。当然，有些人认为我们自己很重要，当然自己也很重要，但在这个基础上，我觉得利他的这个心呢，非常非常的珍贵。我们现在的这个社会非常需要一颗利他的心。我个人认为，或者说是大乘佛教的观点来讲，是利他是生命的最有意义的，害其他人的话呢，这是生命当中最没有意义的。
Different people have different perspective about the meaning of life, and like some people think that be rich is the meaning of life. Some people think have a good looking is the meaning of life. Some people think healthy is the meaning of life. And for people do sports and celebrities and farmers, workers, scholars, they all have different view on the meaning of life. However, I think the most important thing or the most meaningful form of life is to help others. Have an altruistic mind is, it can make our life meaningful. And some people think that we ourselves are important. I think it's okay for you to think yourself is important. But on top of that, I think our society really need an altruistic mind. And I think it's very precious. Altruistic mind is precious. And in Mahayana Buddhism, we see that altruism is the most meaningful thing. And any thoughts or actions to harm others is the worst thing.
相信在座的同学们有很多问题也想要问堪布，那么接下来的时间就留给大家。
I know you all have a lot of questions in mind for Kenpo at this moment. Well, the rest of the program is dedicated to a Q&A session for you and Kenpo.
So, I'm a Muslim, and the most basic aspect of Islam is that we are born in this life to pass to the eternal life. So everything is impermanent around us.The purpose of life serves as a passage for the eternal life. So we get awarded by the eternal life. So my question is, if like life is impermanence in Buddhism, how do you get rewarded at the end?
其实他这里的恒常生命呢，应该说我们有一个延续的生命。延续的这种生命呢，虽然不是正式，但是我们也承认，因为我们都知道，我们从小到今天，一直到死之前，我有一个比较相同的生命。在相同的生命，如果用智慧来观察，我今天上面观察一样的，不一定成立的。但是呢，在我们的假想当中，这样的恒常生命。也可以成立的。
So, when you talk about eternal life, we can see in another way, continuous life or unceasing life. And we can accept unceasing life, continuous life. We don't think it has intrinsic existence, but from a phenomenal level, we accept its continuity. And we can observe in this way. So from our childhood till now, we have the same life. This is just like what we perceive. But just as what I mentioned earlier, if you examine yourself, the time yourself now, the version of right now and the version of the past or the version when you walked into the room, that similar way, you will find that life is continuous, but so you can accept that in from this aspect.
佛教当中还有我们的这一辈子，还有在下一辈子，你积善当中造的善业或者是恶业呢，就在下一世当中呢，也会感受到快乐和痛苦，就这么一个延续的生命。但这样的延续的生命呢，并不是常有。所以常有跟延续有一定的差别，
So in Buddhism, we see this or present life, future life. And what we do in this life, it's, if we do virtuous actions or non-virtuous actions, then we will experience happiness and suffering accordingly. And we see this the continuous life, but this is not permanent.
因此我认为基督教也好，伊斯兰教也好，佛教也好，很多的宗教对生命的分析方式不同而已，实际上是都是一样的。
So, from my point of view, I think no matter it's Christianity, Islam, or Buddhism, although we have different approaches to understand life, but ultimately the meaning are the same.
康普你好，我是在哥大学习人文专业的一名研究生。就是我最近在想一个事情，我认个人认为作为一个成年人，需要首先承担经济独立的这个责任，给父母对我们的投资和自己的未来的家庭争取一个经济安全感。但是我很多其他学习人文专业的同学都觉得我这个想法很俗，在二十多岁的时候靠父母完成学业也是可以的，他们认为价值不能完全通过金钱来衡量。这个观点我个人是同意的，但是我认为取得一个经济安全感也是生活的一个必须。作为一个成年人，我想问一下您怎么看待这两个观点呢？谢谢。Hello. So my question is, I'm currently a master student studying humanities at Columbia. So personally, I think that as an adult, we have to be financially independent to pay back what our parents have to pay for our tuition and to.And financial independence for our future family. But many of my colleagues in humanities, in the Department of Humanities, they disagree with my idea. They think that in their mid-20s, it's okay for their parents to pay for the tuition for them to pursue their academic achievement. And they think that value couldn't be judged based on monetary, on solely on monetary value. I agree with this, but I think that as an adult, like,also crucial to achieve a financial independence and security. I wonder how you understand these two views. Thank you.
我对你的具体情况不是特别清楚，但是呢，一般我们的很多亚洲的一些留学生啊，他们到了西方以后呢，已经过了十八岁，但是经济上经常靠父母。然后思想上呢，就不愿意就受到父母的约束，就所以依靠西方的一种方式来跟父母，就有自己的梦想和自己的思想。但是在西方呢，好像也不是，基本上好多都是不是这样的。因此，我看你选择的过程当中呢，可能因为根据自己的情况，梦想也很重要的。但是按照我们的一些方式的话呢，可能不依靠，就是他们的话，也许可能连梦想成真呢也有一定的困难。因此，暂时来讲呢，如果你要想梦想不断的去成真的话呢，还是要暂时依赖这个父母或者说是其他的，然后在将来的这个人生当中也。通过其他方式来解决这件事情。
So because I don't know the specific situation, I cannot share my clear view on this. However, from what I know, I have seen a lot of Asian students. They are more than 18 years old, but they are dependent financially on their parents. However.On their thoughts, they are not dependent on their parents. They don't want to listen to their parents. They said to their parents that because in the West, everyone has a free idea, we can think freely, we should do that. So they are not copy Western style completely. They just choose what can do good for themselves. However, I think becauseAt this time, you want to pursue your dream, and your dream is also important. And if you cannot support yourself right now. If you have to rely on your parents financially, I think temporarily it's okay for you to do that because your dreams is also very important. In order to make your dreams come true, I think it's acceptable if you have to accept their financial supports.
感谢大师的开示。那我的问题可能比较细节一些，就关涉及到我们每天平时的日常生活。就您刚刚说到这个，我们内心的平和以及这个我们烦恼的消除，那可能是需要思维，经常思维细无常，也就是内观，自己观自己内心来解决，来达到。那我的问题就是，如果这些宏观的无常，就是一些生命当中的 tragedy happen 来的时候，我们怎用什么样的方法来观察自己的内心，观察我们的这些想法，也就是观察这些细无常来消除这些烦恼呢？ So my question is the peace of our heart and also all the troubles that we have, we can get rid of them by observing our own heart. So my question is, when the microscope impermanence came, all the tragedies happened in one's life, what are the ways that we can practice to observe our own heart and in order to get the peace and lovely life? Thank you.
生命当中遇到一些比较大的这样的悲剧的时候呢，有两种方法。有一种方法，通过观想粗无常的方法来面对这件事情。那这是我们前面讲到的一样的，你首先人生无常、寿命无常、万事万物无常的道理有一定的概念，那么这个时候自然而然这种想法就出来，包括我个人在家里面的人死了，或者说我自己生病了，就这个时候我马上想出来这个粗无常的这种观念，我不会伤心和担忧。
So when we encounter some tragedies in our life, there are two ways for us to contemplate.And the first one is still from the perspective of the chaos or gross impermanence. And how to do that? So we know our life is impermanent and every single phenomena is impermanent. And we think like for some like personal cases as like when you have some family members die and when you are diagnosed with some bad disease, then you should accept this is something inevitable. It happens because everything is impermanent.
观察细无常时，平时你可以认识到空性。那么遇到这些悲剧的时候呢，你就安住在自己的境界当中。安住在自己的境界当中，就这个时候所有的这些痛苦全部烟消云散。
And the second one is still through the approach of observing subtle impermanence. And to do that, you have to do a lot of practice on emptiness. So when any tragedy happens in our life, you should just meditate and resignon this state of emptiness.
或者你们连个问也可以，我一起回答。
谢谢上师。我先自我介绍一下，我叫丽丽，我是一个9个月大 baby 的妈妈。就是在我 baby， 就是我刚刚怀孕的时候 ，baby 不是特别的好，所以那个时候我就经常去念经。然后现在baby 9个月了，就是很活泼，很健康。我也觉得很开心。那我想问一下，就是我希望就是这个宝宝以后更多的能够去接近佛，去学佛。那么我应该做一些什么呢？能够让他更加去接近一些。So I'm a mom of a 9-month-old baby. When I was pregnant, the baby, I was quite worried, maybe because with the baby prepared. So
she chanted sutras
a lot. So
So my question is, what should I do to make the baby more, welcome Buddhist to the heart? So yeah, that's my question.
看不我的问题是，就是说，我有的时候就是说明明知道我这件事情做的是不对的，但是我会因为太过于执着，然后就一直去做。就像我其实是有强迫症的，就是说我会想一个问题，会一直钻着，一定要想到这个问题，我这样做确实是对的，然后我才会心里舒服，然后就会给我造成很大的困扰，因为我每天七八个小时都不断的在想这些事情，没有办法就集中精神去读书、去念经。虽然我也很认真的去念经，但是实际上，这个强迫症我知道是业障病，但是如何可以去除这个业障病，使我通过哪些方法减轻我每天想这件事的时间，或者是要一直去克服呢？还是可以有什么方法使它可以对症下药的？
English
is not very good, so please translate.
Okay. So briefly, her question is because she spend like 7 to 8 hours every day to think, contemplate, reflect what she should do, she should not do, because when she realized that she should not do anything, but she still force herself to do it, a lot of times that happens. So she wants to get some insight from Kenpo about this.
刚才第一个问题，可能你的小孩就如果想接上佛方面的愿，那么经常让他念经啊、磕头啊，就是这样，可能就慢慢会好的。
So the first question, if you want to make your baby make a good connection with Buddhism, you can ask him or her to chant prayers, sutras, and also ask her or teach her or him to do prostration.
我想问一下，念什么经是最好的呢？
Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mara Padzanata, 就开智慧的。第二个，就是可能需要，按照佛教的教义，可能你是如果信仰佛教，就可以多念一点这个忏悔的咒语，同时呢，通过修行呢，就是尽量的心就是比较宽松，比较放松，就不要。对一件事情每天都是静止定止，这样的话压力就越来越大，所以这种方法呢应该多做禅修，就是通过禅修让心的戒就可以打开，就只是最好每天早上起来的时候或者晚上睡觉之前长期性的，这样的话一段时间以后会好的。
For the second question, the second lady, you can do mantras for purification practice. That's one thing you can do if you are a Buddhist, you can do that. And the second one is, because you can do that, then you can have your mind relaxed. And also you can do meditation in the morning or at night. And do not cling to the things that you think a lot.And if you can do that, a lot of meditation for a long time, then you will have less stress and you will be able to deal with those problems.
非常感恩，
非常感恩。清明上师您好，我是长岛慈济人文学校的一个老师，我很开心看到我们慈济的祝福。我在国内的一个开封大相国寺。是中国十大龙寺之一，我曾经在那里作为在家居士好多年了。我非常开心来到美国，能够得到上师佛家上师的这种亲身聆听您的教诲，特别感恩。我对无常的理解是，您的理解好像是大悲观的不好的死亡的疾病的这个事情，然而佛家讲大悲大喜。大彻大悟，我想知道您是什么因缘使您大彻大悟，从普通的一个老师，然后修行出家，然后普度众生，让我们得到更多的智慧。谢谢您。
So the question part is, how have you become realized that you have a greater awakened mind, and how you become a great Buddhist master from a teacher?
就是如何能够像您这样有智慧？对。
我没有，既没有大彻，也没有大悟。但确实我对无常还是有个很好的这种观念。
I haven't achieved enlightenment yet, but I do have a good view on impermanence.
我做什么事情呢，都经常就想这个无常的道理。
No matter what I do, I always contemplate on impermanence.
比如说，我跟别人在佛教道场的一些合作的话呢，我也会想，这个无常会不会有？佛教道场方面的一些合作啊，就弘法方面的。
Okay, so when I have some cooperation with other people to do Buddhist activities in monasteries, I do have a lot of impermanent ideas.
我以前讲过很多的关于无常方面的法，然后修行以后呢，很多人的这种心理还是有一定的收获。
I have taught a variety of Buddhist practices on impermanence, and through those practices, a lot of people find it's very useful.
今年年初的时候，我翻译了一个，就我的老师，法王吉美彭措的，一个无常的歌，叫做是瀑布妙音，就是道歌。
And at the beginning of this year, I translated a teaching from my teacher, Kenchen Jimin Pintu Rinpoche, and its title is, or you can see, it's Doha on Impermanence, or Dharma Sound on Impermanence, and it's the melodious sound of waterfall.
那么这个道歌呢，就是当时在藏地比较早期吧，就是发生就是特别大的变化的时候呢，法王造的。
And this was composed by him, Kenchen Jimin Pintu Rinpoche, when there was very big things happened in Tibet long time ago.
共有32个颂词。
It has 33 verses.
最后一个颂词说是，如果我们有智慧能观察的话呢，其实万事万物的一切的法呢，都是知道无常的最好的导师。
And the last verse says that if we can use wisdom or intelligence to examine all phenomena and find that the manifestation of all phenomena, the impermanence of all phenomena, is actually the best spiritual teacher of impermanence.
它会引领我们从人生的路走向光明的道。
And it can guide us to the bright side of our life.
那么这个道歌也有藏文，也有汉文，也有英文。
And it's available in Tibetan language, Chinese, and English.
我也希望我们在座的很多人，不仅仅是一个口头上会说能辩的一个知识分子。
And I hope that everyone here, you should not just be satisfied to be an eloquent scholar or intellectual.
而且真正成为智慧的行动的实践者。
And but at the same time, to become someone can really apply wisdom, apply theories into your practice.
对人生有觉悟和有感悟者
，and have some awakening idea of your life。
我觉得人生当中的觉悟真的很重要。
I think it's very important for us to have some realization and awakened ideas about our life.
所谓的人生觉悟呢，并不是是你因为今天看到了什么光明啊，看到了什么佛菩萨，不一定是这样。
And when we talk about some awakening ideas or a realization of our life, it's not the idea of seeing some luminosity or Buddhas or Bodhisattvas.
就是要通达基本的为人处事的人格，人格方面的知识。
But to understand how to deal with interpersonal relationship, how to become a good person.
更重要的认识我们自己的心。
And what's more important is to recognize the nature of our mind.
让我们感受地狱的痛苦的话，也是依靠这颗心。
When we experience the suffering in the hell realms,It was this mind.
让我们感受天人的天堂的快乐的话，也依靠这颗心。
When we experience the happiness of the celestial realm, it's also this mind.
如果我们对自己的心有所感悟
，If we can understand, can realize the nature of our mind,
你的人生当中有机会当过往坐在金宝座上的话呢，也不一定很傲慢。
So if you have this kind of realization, even if you are a king or emperor sitting on the throne, you will not have any arrogance or pride.
你的人生当中因为不幸，最后沦落到乞丐，人人践踏你的时候，你心不一定很脆弱。
And if something unfortunate happens, you become homeless. When people belittle you, you will also not feel so fragile, so weak.
因此，我始终觉得是我们每一个人呢，应该对内心的认识、对内心的洞察，这是非常有意义的。
So therefore, I think.It's very meaningful for us to examine our mind and have the realization of the nature of mind.
所以我为了用完我的时间，我就发挥这么多。
So in order to use up all the time given to me, I just want to share with you this much.